the ultimate gathering of friends. A true community of countrymen and hunters. Fraternity like no other. Everyone's favorite day of the year is here. The day every beater and picker-up loves, and every keeper dreads. It's Beater's Day. Ant, the little guy from the clay tour, is also an exceptional gamekeeper on a beautiful private estate. And he is helped by his enthusiastic underkeeper.
One to seven out here.
One to seven out here.
Rayan, aka Winkles.
Welcome to Beater's Day, mate.
Thanks, headkeeper.
It's all right, mate. It's all right. We're here.
Finally.
Yes.
We've had a hell of a season, mate.
It's not been bad.
I'm happy to be done with, mate. We shot over on every day. We've not got the numbers left, but we're going to go and have a good day.
It's felt like a long season this season.
We've got nice weather. It's not particularly windy, but it's overcast and
overcast, it's cold.
Nah, that's something. Always a good one. It's dry. Me and you are going to be on the same team today, mate.
I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Second time this season.
We haven't been next to each other. We haven't, mate.
We might have to engineer that.
Well, look at the cards, mate. You know, we should fiddle it.
Well, if we should have one or two and everyone else can do what they want.
That sounds fair enough. Yeah. Sounds fair enough. As long as nobody gets shot, mate, and we get shot, then I'm happy.
That'll be a good day.
That's it. Let's go pull some numbers. Let's go do a safety brief. Get down the way. Enjoy ourselves.
Right, good morning everybody, welcome to Beater's Day. We're going to split everybody up into the teams to start with. We're going to draw pegs for those teams. We're going to do it to walk one, stand one. I'm going to run one team, Ryan's going to run the other team, and then we'll go through the safety briefing after we've done all that. If I can have on this side of the gate, please, myself, Johnny, James, Luke,
over here, boys, please, and Spike.
Is there a fat one that's going to be picked last?
Yeah, that's you, Dave. Is there anybody else who has turned up to shoot today that has not been given a team? That's a good start. That is a good start. I will pick my teams first. We've got 10 guns on my team.
10 pegs.
Thank you very much.
Tony, you're the next person to turn up. Andy Brady. We're going to move up three guys, okay? So we're going to do walk one, stand one. We'll probably do three drives standing. You're going to move up three.
Keep your card. That'll keep you reminded of where you need to be.
Okay. First of all, start by thanking the beaters who've turned up today. We've got Pete, Dee, George, Dave and Tom. They've come to give us all a hand. I want to thank them for turning up. Biggest thing today, guys, there's a lot of us out. A lot of guns in play. Safety is paramount. Safety is everything. I want plenty of blue sky up around everything. If it's safe and it's low, you know, if you want to kill it and you're happy to kill it, then by all means kill it, as long as it is safe. That is the main thing. Safety is everything. Plenty of woodcock about. Again, woodcock fly low, they fly fast, they move about a lot. Make sure it is safe if you're going to shoot woodcock. And if you're going to shoot it, I would bloody well hope you're going to take it home and eat it. Apart from that, guys, it's really just a case of enjoying your day. This day is your day. It's our way of saying thank you very much for coming here all year, for helping us out. I think you'll all agree we've had a belter of a year. It's been absolutely phenomenal. We'll go out and we will do everything we've got. We will do what we've got for you. We will do our utmost, and I hope you enjoy the day. The drive will finish with the horn. That is your key to unload and make your way off peg.
What drives we do?
I'm not going to tell you that until we decide who wins the toss. No. I was going to say Winkles. I'm calling tails. Come on.
No.
I am.
All right, I'm shooting first. There we go. Yeah, I'm pulling rank, mate. That's how it works.
No, you said flip a coin, so we're flipping a coin.
Yeah, and I'm calling tails.
Right, that's all right.
I've got heads.
Right, okay.
Down the drain.
It's heads, Winkles. What do you want to do, mate? Do you want to shoot first or do you want to beat first?
I'll shoot first, Blake.
You're going to shoot first?
I'll shoot first.
Okay.
Off to the first drive we went. The other team was shooting first, This meant it was our team's job to drive the game towards them as best we could.
We are walking first. There's three of us on this flank. We're going to walk it up that little hill just there. All the guns are in the valley. I'm carrying a gun just in case, as Ant said, there are any foxes or anything going back when everyone else is in position. Oh, bait is there.
Will do, mate. Tell us when you want us to move.
This is Luke's Nico. I borrowed it for some hedge bashing. One of the greatest guns ever built, the 5000 Mark II. Hey, hey.
Hey.
Ant, mate, do you want us to get in the pen or do you want Tony in the pen yet?
No, yeah, mate, just hold on the side for now.
Change! So we've just come inside the pen. It's about now just carefully getting the birds to walk where we need them. They are a wild entity and they will fly wherever they want, back, forwards, wherever. This is a careful science beating. Whenever birds are flying back and out of the line, the pleasure of carrying them, the privilege of carrying them on the line, means you are allowed to shoot them. The point is obviously to get as many birds forward as possible. However, Ant has just said there could be a fox in here, so one shot, one cockbird.
Okay, Johnny, a little bit more your side, mate.
Hey!
When we had flushed all the birds from cover, the drive was over. From the sound down in the valley, and the smiles when we eventually walked down there, we clearly did an okay job.
So a lot of birds going back over your head, with no shooting,
well,
and a cold
of them.
And I saw birds going back
over him. But then I forget the ginge.
He's ginge.
He's terrible with a shotgun.
Yeah, ginge will not shoot unless he's actually told to shoot.
20-foot ginge, not
yeah.
Pickup will be there.
Right. Do you know, mate, I almost brought the old Bretta out today.
What have you got?
That rib on that is incredible.
We could develop on that if you have a chance.
Nico, is that like a copy of a Maruku?
No, factory next door, pretty much. No, factory up the way.
Right, okay. That's a hell of a rib. I'll give
it that.
Pretty
cool, isn't
it? Yeah.
Now it's our turn to stand. I'm on 8. Look with Ant this drive, he's in the best spot. Go on in, Sash. Hop on in. Back on in. We're gonna go do Quince's boys. Bring that back over, there'll be a flush of ducks early doors, but they're gonna be a little bit naughty.
The most uncomfortable I've ever been in my life.
I could make it more uncomfortable for you if you like, Sash.
Oh, does that make it more awkward?
Stop it.
I'll end up spanking you.
Talking my language now.
Bring it.
We're here on the second drive. This is my first stand for my team. This is Quince's drive. We have a cover crop up on the back of this hill for the start of the season, where we generally bring the birds early doors. Once the crop gets too thin and the birds get a little bit jumpy, we take them back across into the wood here and we drive them out there. We've got a little bit more control over them, so we're going to do that one. I've drawn number one peg. Well, I actually drew number two peg, but I give my beautiful wife number two peg, because that's a better peg. I'm just going to back gun here and see how we get on. Hopefully the ducks should come our way. Pheasants probably not so much, but be a mixture of both, hopefully. Ducks first, pheasants later. See if I can't hit something. The old 20 ball. Gun's broke. Can't shoot it.
That's it. We're finished. First drive of the day. And the gun that Johnny told me to get is screwed. So I'm going to try my best to try and fix it, but the ducks are going.
No, I'm not here, no. No, I'm not here. So I heard Lewis at Sport Time. That's his problem.
What's happened?
I might have exited.
I'll give you your certificate of gunsmithery by the end of the day. I shot two pigeons.
Really?
Oh yeah. And the duck didn't come around this far, unfortunately, for a shot, but I shot two pigeons. Hydro rod threes. So once again, I brought out the game stock on the other action because it's a game stock. And I must admit, I've shot the other one on clay, so it's an amazing clay game. It's a little bit too rigid for clay. So we might take a little bit off the rib of that. This is an interesting turny of you. More birds will be coming soon. I heard a rumour that Ant's gun wasn't actually broken at all, and it was just that he thought his mojo was lost having Sasha stood next to him, so he sent Sasha A for a run, which is hilarious. And, I mean, that's it really. There's only an A. Shooting with your friends and people you've been working with all year on a beating team or a picking up team or a shoot team is a wonderful experience. Suddenly you're not really concerned with yourself as much as everyone else, and that is the best side of what we do. Being happy to see your friend shoot is great, apart from Andy, who shoots everything good that's coming on. James! Go on, James! I think that is mostly us. A lovely first drive for us boys. We'll get back to beating in a minute.
Beaters' Day is always at the end of the season. So for most of us, this is the last day out. And with each drive, the feeling of conclusiveness rises. But before we get too sentimental, we're all pretty keen to find out what happened to Ant's gun.
Carriage in and shut it up, then it wouldn't shut. It was only going to there, the top lever wouldn't come across, and it was like solid. So I ended up stripping it down on the peg. I sat down on my peg, got everything off of it, got the barrels out of it, and the cartridge had at the bottom of the brass.
Is it an inferior cartridge brand?
Ah. Somehow it managed to like peel up and wedge it outside but stuck in the chamber. I managed to get it out and then rebuild the gun up.
At any point you go...
James, do you want to jump in there, mate? You can get in, even if it's standing room.
Back to beating this drive, Ant was in charge of the team and line, as he is on every shoot day here.
So guys, 1-7 right here.
1-7's out here, 18, the boss is clearing.
Except today, he had the pleasure of Sasha's company.
So we're in the beating line here today on this drive. We're the main line, so we have three lines that run on a shoot day in a horseshoe shape. The guns make the fourth line. So the idea is that all the birds are driven from a large area of habitat forward through the fourth line. We're the central line, so we're the main line in the middle. We're going to push everything straight from here to the guns. And we've got a team, which is Johnny out by over by the cow shed. He's going to bring that strip of woodland in on the left hand side. And we've got James out on the far right hand side. He's going to bring the right hand side in to the edge of our line. But once we've gathered all those three sides in and we've got the birds collared, that's when the flushing generally goes on. So that once we've run them into a holding point, to a flush point, then we take our time. Be quite a quick movement in and then slow it right down in the end to the flush point.
Around back, I walk all the way from East St. Louis to town.
As a gamekeeper, what are your thoughts on beating noises, mate? Do you have a preference? Do you think any are just completely unacceptable?
No, I think the more ridiculous, the better. So, back in the day, when we were younger in the college days, we used to try a bit of dale, dale, and somebody else would have to reply. That was a classic. These days...
I've stopped, held back my footpath.
Okay, mate. I think the more ridiculous you can make it, the better. I think now I'm a head keeper, I have to be slightly more responsible and not make the daft noises. But I do like a solid or a ah. It's very similar to my noise when I'm missing plays, which is but you can make anything you want, mate. If you can think of a new one, a new craze, let's start it off. We'll start a new trend.
as they're more blanking into the drive, into that flush point we're talking about where the heavy cover is. We're going to gather all these birds up, push them into one solid point. Look, here they go again. And once we've got them gathered up, that's when we can control them in front of the gun line. Dogs are doing the work at the moment. Once we get closer, the dogs will be pulled in and we'll be doing the work, walking them out slowly. So we'll keep going, keep bringing them in.
Okay, let's go into the pen, please. Just get a tap on the side of the pen. Make sure Will's on the corner because James has got a lot of birds stuck on that side of the wire.
Yeah, a lot of birds running them roadies in front of you, Johnny, so when we get you moving, mate.
Evans is back in the beaters room. It's always a treat here. But on beaters day, the feelings are all turbocharged.
Beast.
More food, more chat, more laughter. Reflections are made on the season and the day. And long-standing jokes are brought to a close. All before going back out into the field to look for some more birds.
That could be the most romantic thing I've ever seen. Ant McLernan sharing a peg with his wife. He doesn't like to let on that he's a real softie. That's a nice shot right there. If you cut down the tree and had a big lens sash, you'd be able to capture it in photographic composition for the rest of time.
Photographic composition.
Oh, that bollocks about romance. That's not actually him stood with her. James! It's fairly common for me, but 11s has killed my shooting ability completely. It's going to take a couple of shots just to remember how to do it. About 150 so far, so it feels. Yeah, a lot less lead. We all tend to get a bit excited and they have a little break in your head. The sight pictures of you shooting these birds makes it feel like you're shooting 800 yard pheasants. So you just get, ooh, open the gaps up, open the lead up, pull away, lots of speed, and actually all you're doing is missing. Well, after all that banging at ducks with less than average success, that pheasant made me feel a bit better. It's almost the end of the drive. There will be a few more pheasants left in here, but generally the pheasants come out the other end of this drive to the line of guns over their back end. Introspective thinking about how I don't make the same mistakes the next time.
As is often the case, I left my attention and ability at the 11s table. In the modern world, where ability with a gun on game is all too often tied up with ego, it's important to remember why we do this.
Get it out a bit better. The rest of us will take this down and then we'll put down the track and cut him when we need to cut him.
Throwing a tantrum because you missed a few birds is pretty pathetic. Sportsmanship is never overrated and is the basis of the community we live in. It's not hard to get into game shooting now, and some of the old values have been pushed aside. I've said in previous videos that updating our values and social taboos is probably in order in 2022. And I stand by this sentiment for everything other than sportsmanship.
We'll go down and just walk in. If anybody's guns that are in the game cart will be down there, I need to go get them. If anybody's guns that are in my truck will be up here.
No. Yeah. You got one already over there. Three, four. All right, that'll do then.
Last drive of the day. Beaters day is A, fantastic, and B, a real marker. These videos for me, I always look back and see it's a good marker for change. But last drive, let's find a few ducks, relax, enjoy ourselves. Watch Andy and all his magnificence over there in the hot seat. This is one of my favorite drives to just stand and watch, to be fair. The birds are coming over a real big spreader line. And they're coming just, here we go. It's always melancholic, I think I say this every year, but it's always melancholic, isn't it, the end of the season? Joyous that it's done, but sad that there's a wait until the next season and the year starts again for us shooters. You never know what the next year is going to hold, and inherently every year brings a lot of change between the end of the season and the start. Before the season ends, I do need to say a thank you to this game. It has looked after me very well this season. I've had me off days and me off drives and me good drives, but you often sort of forget that not without these it wouldn't be possible, because of course it would be, but. Guns bring us all a lot of joy. Not, I mean, through their existence sometimes, but through their using. Here you go, Sash. These things just bring a lot of smiles, not through only through existence, but the memories that they give us. And I know I've said it multiple times, it doesn't matter whether it's a Bakel or a Cyberside non-ejector Spanish no-namer. The memories you make with these in your hand are very special. This has also been an end to my season of steel. To be fair, it's going to be a lifetime of steel, isn't it, to be blunt. The end of the season. I'm constantly amazed at the progress we've seen in a few seasons. And I know that people go, you're selling us down the river by not fighting for lead, but I feel like that fight is lost. We're better off fighting for a future together and finding something that is plenty. And I think over the course of this season, I have been impressed with some of the birds I've shot, certainly with these threes in steel. And I can only see things getting better, however bleak it is. Cue old boys saying, we got sold by down the river by Basque.
For many, the summer's going to be filled with some other hobby or putting your nose to the grindstone, saving money or time off for next season. But for the gamekeepers, this just signals the start of a new year. The cycle begins again.
Okay guys, just want to start off from me and Ryan and from the family, although they're not here, to say thank you very much for all your help this season. It's much appreciated. It might be the last one we do, we don't know. Times are a bit difficult on the estate at the moment, but if it is, I just want to say thank you very much for your help and your support all the way through. I know me and Ryan, speaking for both of us, we're both very grateful for everything you do and every time you turn up. Hopefully today's reflected that a little bit. We've done everything we can for you. Hope you all had a good day. Well done for being safe though, that's the main thing. Nobody's done anything ridiculous. Just want to give a couple of bits out to the guys who help out regularly. So Ryan, do you want to grab a couple of bits for Pete D?
Your southern mother and family.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you very much, guys. And thanks again for turning up today. I know you didn't have to. We appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Well, may I say, it's been amazing. I've really enjoyed it. And as I say, fingers crossed we're with you wherever you are.
Now, oh, the lady of the moment.
Yeah.
Come on, Jane.
Come on, Jane.
Come on. Jane turns up when she can. She's been busy with work this time, but she always helps me out organising everybody. And she comes and when we've had too many pickers up, she's always offered never to have a pay packet or anything. So we just want to say thank you, Jane. Thank you very much, guys. Much appreciated. I want to say thanks to Winkles. If he does end up going somewhere else this year, then it's been a pleasure, mate.
It has indeed.
And well done, and we hope you all the best, mate. We wish you the best.
Thank you very much.
Let's go down the pub. Gonna go down the deers up. Gonna have a sherbet. We've got some chips on down there and some food. Thanks again, guys.
There's a real mix of emotions at this point. Joy at memories made. Melancholy that this chapter is closing. And excitement that a new chapter will be opening very soon. Thanks for watching. We will see you next year.